Arrgh, I'm a pirate with wings. Hello, guys and girls, this is Chokester, and welcome back to Chokester Plays FTB Unstable. We are now in episode 9, and now that I have the angel ring, I'm able to fly around, and I just found a town. So, let's take a look. I scoped out, there's the blacksmith over here. I know how we always love loot. Oh, there's some books in there. I think I'm pretty good on books, but I know how we all love loot, so let's take a look together. Ooh, not bad, not bad. Okay, we want that. You can see I've been out exploring quite a bit. The little opening clip of me near the pirate ship, I got lots of stuff from that. So let's dump some of this stuff real quick. Oh, you know what? Good enough. Let's take the pulsating iron, redstone alloy. We like the ender. I'll show you what that does. That matches my armor, and that, and sure, why not? We'll take that. That'll go in our bag. All right. So just wanted to enjoy that with you on screen, and we might come back and check these guys to see if any of these, remember we tried, we found one guy in our third town. So if you look at all my waypoints, we have these towns. So we go town 1, town 2, town 3, and town 4. And so far we've checked the first two towns, nobody was a taker. Third town we found one person. We didn't really explore it fully, or I should say check everybody there. So we might have another person in town 3 for a villager contract, but now we have a fourth town. So it's not too far. It's all around here. So I did kind of do a lot more exploring, as you can see. And now that I have the angel ring, it's so much easier. So I'm going to head on home, and we're going to do a couple more things, and then probably go to the end. All right, see you in a bit. And we are back. As you can see, I have picked up a couple of banners from the pirate ship. Kind of goes along with the black and white theme. We are going to need to go to the end. And I'm hoping to do it this episode. So a couple things we want to do is we want to make a living wood bow. And so that requires mana-infused string and some living wood twigs. So let's go outside. Let's drop our string in here. Let's make a few of these. Oh, and we now have a living wood bow. There's another bow that from Batania. I mean, really our bow options are limited. So we have the vanilla bow. We have the blood magic bow. Don't have anything blood magic started yet. We have the one we just made, and which uses arrows, and then the crystal bow, which uses mana. So love to have that, but that requires dragonstone. And if you see, dragonstone requires the portal Alfheim, and we're probably not going to do that for an episode or two. So next thing I want to do is make an enchanter, because this bow is not very powerful by itself. So let's make an enchanter. And we dump off this stuff. And the other thing we're going to need is a book and quill. And we'll grab that. Let's put the enchanter down right here. I always forget how much it takes, but if we look at the recipes, I think it's this one right here is power. So we want to add power 4. And so we need the flint and some amount of lapis. And that's going to be 35 levels, so let's grab not enough. All right, so I guess I'm going to need to go grab some levels. Now, I could put a lower level of power on there, but I really want to do this. So I'm going to go to probably the Nether and mine a bunch of quartz, because we're going to want that even more so in the future, and it's a great way to gather experience. So I'll be right back with the experience. Okay, here's something I had no idea. Watch what happens when I look at my inventory, okay? Watch what happens when I mine nether quartz. Gather all this experience. All right, it's nowhere to be found. It's the oddest thing. Except when we look in here, it's been gathering all the stuff in here. I didn't realize you can shift right click on here and it tells it to go directly into the bag or not. And so if I do this, you'll see I had shift right clicked and now it goes into my regular inventory. Pretty cool. I learned something new today. Just wanted to share that. All right, be back. After a successful trip, I now have 33 extra levels. So I'll grab two more, put this in here. I now have enough to grab my power 5. See how much it's going to take to add it to this bow. 5 more. 2, 3, 4, 5. And we now have a power 5 bow. Okay. Excellent. Works well, I guess. All right, so let's take... I know I'm going to need this, and might have to grab a few more, but we're going to need Eyes of Ender. So let's grab three of these. If we put them in the alloy smelt, or the segmel, I mean, it will give us significantly more. Let me wait for this to get finished. See how many we get per one. Look at that. 4 per. 8 per. All right, and also let's grab some more of this, see if this makes a difference. And yep, I guess we just, yeah, it's fine. Okay, let's put these in here. Let's put this in here. Grab 12 Eyes of Ender, and we'll head off towards, where would it be? It was, so it's off that way. Okay. That way. All right, you guys have all seen this before. I will be back when I find the stronghold. We're back. One of the things I wanted to grab was this glass bottle because we have, well, actually it was right, one of them was right there, this Ender Air bottle we can use in Batania, and also we can get Dragon's Breath. So I'm going to be collecting some of that as we fight. So here we go. Wish us luck. Hello, Mr. Dragon. Let's get these things right away. Near me. Miss me with your dragon's breath. Right near me. There you go. Hey, bud. One more left. I missed one. Now you have no way to heal. Wow, that's loud. Alright, let's collect some Dragon's Breath. From right here, but I guess that's not. Gotta be on the ground. I know, bud. Grab a few of those. Oh, there's some dragon breath. I'll take that. Alright. I'm gonna do this before the battle ends. Did I get them all? Yeah. Right, Ender Air, 15 dragons. Oh, that should be plenty. Thank you. Oh, the other thing I put on here was put on this. Turn this way down. Okay, so I put infinity on my bow, just so I didn't have to deal with it. That's... Alright, NEC really hasn't even hit me yet, so I'm in no hurry to kill him. Here he goes. Too bad we don't get yellow hearts anymore, that would be really nice. Sucking all the experience. Alright, no problem. And we're going to want a bunch of those. 65 levels. Okay, I'm going to gather a bunch of this, gather some endstone, and then we'll head on to the next level. So I will check out this first. This ender biotite is from Cork. I don't quite know exactly what it's for. It gets this ender biotite. So let's take a look at what it's used for. There's a weather sensor, some decorative blocks, and that seems to be it. So weather sensor, I mean, I'll grab some. It's fine. But really, we're here to get ender lilies. So, and, you know, we might set up a spawner, but remember, in 110, the Endermen teleport you to them, so especially if they can't get to you. So it's a little bit harder to do a farm like we used to, you know, where you put it two blocks high and they can't get under it, and they just stand near you and you just whack them with no damage. They tend to hit you quite a bit. So more than likely, I'll just go around and kill a few. I want their heads, because there's a lot of recipes later on that are gonna need... Enderman heads. And we can set up a spawner, of course, but the other thing I'll do is, there's the bees here. These are the forest hive, but I think they're different than any standard one. So, yeah, I've got 27 of them already, which isn't bad. I'd like to get 49 to do like a 7x7. That wouldn't be too bad. That would keep us rolling in ender pearls for a long time. Well, pretty much to the point where we have nothing else. So, all right, this is pretty tedious and boring stuff. So let me cut here, and I'll be back when we're ready to go to the next level of the end. We have gathered 5 Enderman head, and of course a ton of Ender lilies and Ender pearls. We've got 15 Dragon's Breath and 48 Ender arrows, way more than enough. And we're gonna head over here. Now, if you've never seen this, this is a 110. There's my platform that I started on. In case you can't see that, it's a bit dark, but it's our platform. And how you get here is, obviously, it's too high. I mean, one block high, we're too high, so you can't get in here. So what you do is you throw an ender pearl in there. Chunk. And then I'm over here. Now, these are really cool new plants. So this is a whole new area. And what we can do is come up here on the top and grab some of these flowers. And once you gather the flowers on here, gathers one more, they have a chance to drop, I forgot what they're called, we'll see it here in a minute, but this also has a chance and it takes out the whole thing, and you'll get other stuff, so you get these chorus fruits. So there's various uses for these. You can also plant these back in the overworld and they will grow, but these are some of the things we want to gather. They are used in some recipes. You have to gather the flowers separately. And I think that's it. I'll gather this. There you go. That's one of the dragon's eye, and that's from roots. And you can use that for, look at, you can create ender pearls out of that. I don't think we're going to be doing that, but I believe there's roots recipes. We haven't started roots yet, but, you know, there's obviously recipes for that. So I'm going to gather some of these, and then we're going to go look for some of the unique structures in here. So hopefully this cutting isn't too bad, but I have a lot planned with this episode, namely to kill the dragon, and just a lot to do. So I don't want to take up too much time doing some of these boring stuff. Exploring is sometimes fun, but most of the time it's not. So, all right, let's cut once more. And there she blows. Now that is not a waypoint on it. It is. Those are my entrances over there. So that's where I came into this portion, and that's where the Ender Dragon was, way back there. So here is some end rod. Now you can actually craft these, but hey, they're already here. I think they're using some recipes, and let's take a look, see what they are. Yeah, nothing here. So maybe they're just decoration in this pack. They have, ooh, some banners. They have some other uses. Now, these banners are also hard to break. So what I found is the best way is just to break that, and they come instantly. And then you can just throw them away at any point. You know, throw away these blocks. Or you can use them for, you know, building if you want. So I'll grab a, that one disappeared. There we go. Got that one. So I'm going to start down below here. And these guys are what's called shulkers, and they send these things at your way. And you'll notice I'm actually flying upwards, and I'm not doing anything. So that's kind of fun. So you'll see I have levitation here, and I can fight against it. I'm holding down, and I can't go anywhere. Let me make sure I don't get into a dangerous situation. But you can knock them down. They're just really tough, so I can't actually fly downward. I have to wait for it to wear off. So they're annoying at best. So what I usually do is just run over here and get underneath. Took them out. It's me. Ah. All right. So if you're in underneath somewhere, you know, it does less damage. But the whole design of this is to, see, I'm already levitating now, is to work your way up if you didn't have flight. You know, vanilla, there is no flight. The best you can get is the new elytra wing. So this is kind of like a jumping maze, but hey, we have flight, so we're going right up to the top. Now there are, get out of here. So there's some cool stuff. I mean, I think these just turn into shards. So there's some cool stuff in a lot of these, but that one was, you know, there's chests and dungeon chests, and there's, you know, all kinds of stuff. But that was an example of one that was pretty tame, pretty boring. So got a couple of banners. We might hang those up. You know, that's part of the new stuff. But what we're really looking for is the ship. So I'm going to fly around. I've already been flying around. Oh, I hate this. When you go to a different level, let me go down here. It's just like in the Nether. See if this does it. Yeah, you can sort of start to see stuff here. But yeah, I've flown all the way around here and kind of been doing a great big circle. So I'm not straying too far. So I'm going to go ahead and get my bearings here. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and go run in a circle and see if we can find another one of those structures. So, you know, I can go in one straight line. I mean, it's no different than finding a town, right? We're flying around. We don't want to get too far to have to run around. So you kind of do concentric circles and see if you can catch one of the randomly generated facilities. I flew around for maybe 4 minutes during that cut. So it's really not too long till you find these things. They're not super rare. So I'm just kind of doing one great big circle here. Keep my eye out, trying to watch the map as well. So. All right, and this is becoming desolate, but it'll pick back up. I'm going to cut again until I find another interesting spot. Be back. And there's the next one. Ooh, and we got a ship. Excellent, excellent. Now we can explore this a little bit further. Hi, shulkers. Oh, quick and under. Ah, oh, missed it. No. All right, we'll have to wait for this to wear off. Like I said, mostly just an annoyance. Let's make sure we eat. All right, let's get down and get him. Okay, let's explore this. Hopefully a little more interesting. Nothing nothing very interesting here. Let me out. I got the floatiness. Wow, that was it. Let's check this over here. Ha, got in. Wow, absolutely nothing. Well, that's unfortunate. Let's check this one. This looks a little more promising, but this is usually where the chests are, right here. And there is nothing. How about up top? Nothing. Well, anticlimactic. That's sometimes what you get. Let's get this guy here. Alright, and then, so this is the ship. Oh, hey, bud. Other one missed us. Oh, got us. Wasn't quick enough. All right, so there should be nothing up here. Nope. Waiting for it to, there it is. Oh, seriously, another one got me. Where is he? Is there another one over here that I missed? I don't see him. Maybe there's one inside. Okay. Now, this is pretty cool. This dragon head, you can actually collect it. It's so slow. All right. And you can wear it. Arrgh. Yeah, I think that's pretty fun. Let's look at him this way, behind. Not too interesting. Okay. All right. Enough silliness. That was fun, though. Let us go inside. Two potions of healing. All right. And we'll take a brewing stand, because we haven't actually made one yet. But to be fair, we just now got... Hey, bud. We just now got blaze rods. So, and there's the elytra wings. There we go. Yay! Not that we'll ever use them. Let's see here. Diamond boots of unbreaking, feather falling 4, and fire protection. Unbreaking 3. So, if there was a way to disenchant, that would be awesome. Now, I know that we can do different types of enchanting, but I don't know of a way to disenchant at all. So, unless I really wanted to use these, they're of no use. It's really unfortunate. So, maybe we'll have a mod in the future that allows us to disenchant, because that would be really nice. We also have the Ender IO enchanter here that is mostly unlimited, but something like mending that this one has... It would be really nice to be able to strip that off and copy the book and so on. By the way, I did see Bibliocraft. Bibliocraft is, I think it was, maybe a couple weeks ago, he had said that he's gotten it working on 189, which was the big hurdle, you know, going from 1710 to 189. That's one of the biggest hurdles. So, you know, and then after that, it's fairly easy, so... Anyway, we got the elytra wings. Oh, what the heck? We'll take that guy, too. Am I completely full? I think I threw some... Yeah, that's right. Better make sure we get this. Let me throw some things in my bag so that we make sure we pick up the elytra wings. Oh, we did get them. Yeah, it's the item frame. Actually, I don't care about it for that. There we go. All right. Cool. And so now we just have the fun task. I mean, I can hunt around. You know, we could, it's 3,500 meters away. Well, I could make you suffer through it with me, but I wouldn't do that. I can't think of anything else really to do in here. There's, you know, it's a lot more involved than it was before, than just the plain old kill the dragon, grab your stuff, and go. I do like this new secondary area. It's kind of cool. It's got whole new plants in here, and it's got new areas, and you know, you could infinitely go through here, almost infinitely go through here and find all those facilities and buildings and you know, gather up stuff. But you know, it's you know, depends on what you're going to find, and that's kind of what you'd find. The chest we just saw is kind of representative of what you find in a lot of these chests. So, is this the one we found before? I don't think it is. Here's another one. Ooh, well, I was just getting ready to cut, so let's give this a try. Nothing in here. Nothing in here. I think it doesn't look like anything's in there. Let's peek through the windows in here. Nothing. Put it in the base down here. You can always see the chest from the windows. Don't hit me. Don't hit me. I don't see anything in there. Miss me. Again. Nope, nothing in there. No chests. That's unfortunate. Ring around the rosy. And I think I checked in here. Yeah. That's, oh, there we go. Whew, these guys are voracious. There we go. Whoa, it sounded like he teleported. That was crazy. All right. Oh, hey, that's a good find. I'll take diamonds. It's a steadfast princess and an ender drone. And, you know, of course, really good enchants on there, but yeah, pretty much all the rest of these I don't need. But I think I might take the ender chest. That's, you know, saves a few ender pearls, although we do have kind of... Oh, there was stuff in there. Wow. Obsidian. I don't see anything. I would have never guessed there was stuff in there. So that makes you wonder... Wait. Oh, that broke into an obsidian. Oh, that's new. Wow. So that didn't actually give me the chest. That just broke into obsidian. Interesting. Okay. Understand. That's why. There was nothing in there. I was thinking, what, you know, where was that linked to? What's on the other side? So, all right. Cool. That was a little bit better. I'm glad we ended up finding something. Let's check this bottom row just in case. Nothing. I think we already checked. Boy, these... Oh, there's two more. Holy crap. That's good times. Breaking and mending. Ooh, an understaff. I would like to play with that. And we'll take diamonds and ambrosia from forestry. I'm not sure what that is. No uses. Is there a recipe for it? Yes, there is. It's royal jelly and such. Yeah, it's bee stuff. So, all right. I don't see anything down here. Well, get out of here. Get out of here. How long? How much longer? That much longer. Now, in theory, there could be stuff in there, but I doubt that. See anything in here, this level? Is that the one we checked? I think that's the one we checked, right? With the ender chest right next to it? Yeah. Oh, you got me again. So yeah, we pretty much have checked all of this, and I really haven't kept track, so that's hard to determine exactly. But you know what, like I said, there's, you know, we got some diamonds out of it, I guess, some obsidian, and frankly that's about it. That's all we've taken from those chests. So, you know, it's not bad loot. It's probably pretty epic if it's vanilla, but you know, that's what this new end area is designed for. So I'd like to see some mods add some cool new stuff in here, you know, just kind of beef this up. That would be really, really nice. There's another chest in there. Is this one I've checked? Yeah, same exact one. All right, I'm out of here. Where's my... There we go. All right, I'm going to cut. I'll see you when I get back. Okay, we're just rolling up on our way we came in. Now, I think you can actually fly over there. It's not too far. I mean, literally, we were, what, 2,000 meters away, and that took me probably 2 minutes. It's not too bad. Sprinting, of course. But I want to show you how to get back. So you can always run down here, grab an ender pearl, and you just toss it through, and boom, we're back. Right? And then we go over here, go to our gateway, which is my term for it. Go to the gateway, and we have just beaten the game. Well, killed the ender dragon. The end dragon, I guess. So yeah, there's the credit. I'm sure you guys have seen this before. I won't make you sit through that. And we're back in our world. So pretty successful. Pretty successful mission. I'm very happy. Very, very happy. So let's check out our loot. So we've got a dragon head. Let's do something with him right now. Where should we put him? I mean, we could put him right here, but that's no fun. We could put him right next to our tracking head. We could put him above. We could put him on the other side. You know what? This wall is really barren. Should we put him over there? Yeah. It's not bad. Not bad. It's a little barren over there. We're hoping to fill that up with all kinds of good stuff. So, yeah. And let's see what else we got. The elytra wings. Yeah, you know. Some magenta banners. I don't know. Maybe we'll frame these two. I don't know where I want that. Yeah. You know, whatever. Banners. Cool. And then, let's see, some obsidian. We got these chorus fruits, and I ended up getting 6 of these dragon eyes, so that'll be fun. And the chorus flowers. We got plenty of endstone to plant our end lilies. We got the ender air bottle. And then we also got the dragon's breath. So if you recall, this is when we were in the pink stuff. I know it was kind of hectic during the dragon battle, but when you're in the pink stuff, I right-clicked with the bottle and picked up dragon's breath. When I was in the dragon's breath, I picked it up. And then elsewhere, I had to look at the ground and kind of right-click the bottle on the end stone, and you picked up ender air. So we can use both of these things for various crafting recipes that we might get into. We got a brewing stand, and then our bag, we got ender pearls. Cool. All right. Well, that was a good time. That was a lot of fun. So I've killed dragon. I've got creative flight. I've got plenty of resources coming in with the miner, with the builder. So I am very happy. So, all right. Well, if you had a good time, I would appreciate a like and subscribe until the next episode, till we talk again. Have a good one. Bye.